It's all over the place.
But yeah, so
grab a drink, grab a snack, bear with me. Let's go to something I am confused about again.
I'm confused a lot in this episode, yes.
Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki, I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today is another Let's Talk Makeup, new makeup releases. It's number 50, which is kind of, wow. So yeah, also, grab a drink, grab a snack. I have a lot, it's going to be a long one. So, yeah. The makeup look I have on my eyes and face, I have filmed. It is my first impression with the Nubian 3 Coral from Juvia's Place, which will come this week. I don't know exactly when, but it will be online this week, because it's still part of my first impression week. That is now in its second week. Just so you know. Anyway, I will link my first impression playlist down below, so you can kind of check out what I did and all that goodness. So yeah, yeah. Let's just get into it. I have water here because I think I will need it. This video series is based on the Will I Buy It series by Samantha March. I will link her playlist down in my description box, and I will also link the community playlist that she was kind enough to create, where, well, basically a lot of creators such as me post these types of videos too. So if you want to binge watch these types of videos, check out the community playlist. I think that was it. Yeah, the sources, go check out my description box anyway, because a lot of information is there. The products I will talk about today should be there. My makeup should also be there. What is definitely there are my sources and some discount codes. It's just that I have so much to talk about today that, yeah, I kind of hope that I have time to link everything for you. Guys, it has been insane this past week. With all the releases, it's just insane. So I have saved a ton. I don't know if I will get through everything, because it kind of depends on how much I ramble and such. And yeah, I don't want to make the video too long. I think, and you know, 30 minutes is long enough for these types of videos usually for me. So let's see how far I get then, shall we? Let me go to the side a little bit so I can put the pictures up there. Oh yeah, and Kitty. He's there. He's kind of cuddling with a bat. So yeah, today he's living in his corner again. So let me start off with an influencer collab. But this is a nice one, or at least I think so. It's this. It's the AMC Limited Collection. They are three brush holders with dots. One says eyes, the other one says be fearless, and then the last one says face. You can purchase them separately, but I think you can also purchase them in a set. And they are created, there are actually a collaboration between Popstash Official and Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner. So yeah, if you follow her, you may see the resemblance of the dots, because that is one of the things that she does a lot in her looks. She likes to do that. And yeah, be fearless is kind of the way that she tries to live her life, you know? Just be fearless and do what you want to do. I think this is so cool. I love Annette to bits. I'm sure a lot of you know her, but I will link her channel down below anyway, in case you do not. Go check her out. She's just amazing. She's very creative. She's also very, very sweet. I've known her for quite some time now, actually. And yeah, go Annette. And I hope that you are able to collab with more brands in the future. And this is just amazing. I'm sure it's going to be one of many. It is a limited collection. I will link the site down below. Go check it out. Okay, next is an update for Hysteria Cosmetics. I talked about them last week. Their Nakey palette. They have new packaging because their packaging manufacturer was unable to replicate the gold interior of their prototype palette. They also added a few new shades. So now you have 9 shades instead of 2. I think they had 6 in the other one. Oh, 7. They had 7 shades in the prototype palette. So now they have 9. I don't hate the color story. It's just not for me. But I did want to give you the update that well, the packaging is different and that you get 9 shades now instead of 7. Okay. Let's go to... Oh, yeah. It is all over the place, my folder. Usually, I kind of save it in order. I have a hair here somewhere. Kind of save it in order. So I start with a drugstore and then segue into indie and more mainstream. That's not the case today. It's all over the place. That's, yeah. So grab a drink, grab a snack, bear with me. Let's start with Too Faced. And I have a few things from Too Faced. Let's start with this, which is their Christmas palette. It's their new Pumpkin Spice palette. I thought they already did a pumpkin. Oh no, that was the gingerbread spice that will be released in September. This is the Christmas collection, which will also be listed. Yeah, also be launched in September, but this is the pumpkin spice. There will be a new set, including a BTS mascara brush and pumpkin spice gloss. Yeah. First off, it's August. Still, summer here is not really over yet, and we are already talking about Christmas, but yeah. Also, pumpkin, for me and for a lot of people, is not a Christmas thing, it's more of a fall thing, so why is this not their fall collection then? You know, pumpkin spice, fall collection, why is this the Christmas collection? Oh yeah, and coming out in September. Let's just move on because I cannot. The next thing that I have from them is this has just dropped. This is their Palm Springs Dream Cocktail Party eyeshadow palette. It retails for $45 or £35. And you also get a hangover spray peach edition and a BTS peach edition. I'm not really hating this. I do think it's nothing new. Yeah, I'm not hating it. It's just... It's another warm-toned palette with pops of color. But I'm not hating it. It's just not for me. To be quite honest with you. And I kind of think that Too Faced is... I don't know what they are doing. They're... Yeah. I like this one better, though, than their pumpkin spice Christmas palette that will release in September. Okay, let's go to something else I don't really get. This is another collab between Jeffree Star and Morphe, and it is apparently lippies. So they have now done a brush set together, which I kind of get. I know that he and the owner of Morphe are friends and know each other. And Morphe is technically a brush company as well. So I kind of get why they did that collab. I got a little bit confused with their eyeshadow collab. Because he said that he wants to make his formula kind of more accessible. But it is not his formula. It's Morphe's formula. And people compare it to his formula, but it should not be the same. Does that make any sense? The Morphe formula in the collab palette should not be the same as his own formula. Because if it is the same, that we are would be ripped off a lot, you know? The formula isn't the same. I know that. I have seen the reviews. But now they are, yeah, doing another collab, and that's lipsticks. And I still don't get this. I understand that the lipstick quality from Morphe is really good. But why though? This just... I don't know. You know, let me know down below what you think about it. I do think that the colors are pretty. And to be quite honest, I don't really... And I think I'm in a minority, but I don't really think that his liquid lipsticks are worth the price. They are not bad, but I have better in my collection. For me, my preference, you know? So, yeah, I think it's kind of, I don't know. It will sell, of course it will sell, but yeah. Maybe it is to get more feedback on the map. I don't know. After the Jaclyn Hill thing drama, I don't know. Let me know down below what you think of it. I don't know about this. And I kinda don't like it either. Do I make sense? Again, let me know what you think down below. Okay, let's go to this from Besame. Which Besame collabed with Disney and they are bringing out their the Sleeping Beauty collection. This is very, very pretty though. Very pretty. I can really see the cartoon. The colors of the cartoon in here. I think that the packaging looks amazing. I think it's really, really pretty. And yeah, if I had Besame money, I would probably grab stuff from this collection. Because I do think it's really, really pretty. So yeah, even the eyeshadow palette, yes, the colors are a bit muted, but I kind of like them. I think it's pretty. I said that already a few times over now. So yeah. Let me know down below what you think of this collection and if you are planning on picking anything up. I'm curious. I have prices here by the way. The Aurora Translucent Powder retails for $18. Then you have a Briar Rose Blush Palette for $35. The Locket Cream Rouge for $18. Lipsticks $24 each. You have 1, 2, 4 shades. Then you have the eyeshadow palette which retails for $68. But then with the base it retails for $78. I don't get that one though. I don't understand. But it... never mind. There's also a mirror for $58. Then you can get the palette for... palette and the mirror for $126. And then the full collection for $269. Which is a lot of money. But I do think it is something unique. You know, it seems to be that the quality, or at least that's the way it looks, that the quality is going to be amazing. And yeah, I don't know. Let me know what you think of it. I do really, really like it. And again, if I had the money, I would buy the full collection probably. Oh yeah. Let's go to... oh yeah. Tarte. Because Tarte has launched their full collection called Fall Feels. This collection will have you fallen for Tarte all season long with endless bonfire looks. You have a Fall Feels Eye and Cheek Palette for $25. The Hig and Kisses Tartist Remix Lip Gloss Trio for $25. Limited edition chrome paint shadow pot for $22. Limited edition lights camera lashes 4-in-1 mascara for $23. Okay, so the lipsticks look pretty. Lip glosses, whatever. Yeah, the eyeshadow palette though, you know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of the BH Cosmetics Mini Zodiac collection. So yeah, I don't hate the layout, I think that's fun. I don't mind kind of weird layouts, as long as it's kind of symmetrical. I do want that though. But yeah, it's a neutral with a pop of blue and green, a little bit of coral. Yeah, for me it's not it. Let's just keep it at that, but I did want to mention it anyway. Okay, let me know what you think of it down below. Let's go to something I got tagged in from Emmy Cosmetics. You see it here, it's their new Serena palette, or Serena palette. Very, very pretty. Oh yeah, it's a collaboration, isn't it? With Serena or Serena Winterler, Serena Winterler. I hope I say that right. It's available for pre-order now. I like the thin packaging. I like that. I think the shades are very, very pretty as well. They're all shimmers. They look gorgeous. It's available on her website. It's limited edition. But why don't I know what it retails for?
Oh, I also have swatches. Oh, those swatches look really pretty though. But you know that I have swatches because you will already have seen the swatches. I just found them. I don't know what it retails for, and it's annoying me, to be quite honest with you. I don't know what her palette usually retails for, but yeah, I do think it's really, really pretty. So I wanted to mention them to you guys. Okay, let's go to Lime Crime. They just released their Brights palette, and now they are releasing their, what's it called again? The Venus Immortalis. It launches September the 9th. It is 8 cool tone shades in 4 finishes. You have matte foil shimmer, sheer shimmer. Oh, and she glows in the dark. I like this one better than their Brights palette, to be quite honest with you. I think this is pretty. It grabs my attention. I don't know what it retails for. Probably the same as their last palette, which I forgot how much it retailed for. So let me see if I can find that real quick for you. Here. $38. So it will probably retail for $38 as well. I don't know if that is worth it. Let me know down below and let me know what you think of it. But this, yeah, I'm kind of getting gothic-y, Halloween-y vibes. So, yeah. It's cute. She cute. Love it. Let's go to something I am confused about again. I'm confused a lot in this episode, yes. It is the new Norvina palette. What's she called again? The Norvina Volume 1. So apparently we will be getting more volumes. It is 25 shades, mattes and shimmers. And it will retail for $60. It is available August 26th, that is Monday, so it will be available today, I think. I'm pre-filming, so I don't really, yeah. Let me know, what do you think? I'm kind of confused by it, but I also kind of like it, and I also kind of not like it. The top two rows are what I wished the original Norvina was. I am kind of torn because when I first saw a picture of this, it did not scream Anastasia Beverly Hills to me. Because, yeah, you know the whole aesthetics of Anastasia Beverly Hills, it's not this. That's the first thing I'm kind of, yeah. Then the color story. I don't know how I feel about that. It is different. Let's say that. I like the two top rows, the purple ones. I like the two bottom rows. They are kind of speaking to me as well. I think that the swatches are pretty. So yeah, you have basically your cool purpley part and then your warmer fally part. I don't know, guys. I don't know what to make of this. Oh yeah, and also the shades don't have names. They have rows and numbers like chess. I kind of like it and I kind of not. Does that make any sense? I feel like I'm rambling. Let's just move on to the next thing because, yeah. Let's go to, what's this? Oh yeah, Benefit. I have two things from Benefit, I think, yeah. So, I saw this and I actually think it's quite cute. It's just, you know, pencil with an eraser. I think it's cute. But these are the new Boing Cakeless Concealers. They are available now on Benefit.com, Ulta Beauty and Sephora. It's a multi-purpose full coverage liquid concealer that hides it all. And yet feels lightweight and doesn't crack cake or whatever. Settle into fine lines. Well, the formula includes algae-derived ingredients. Okay. Okay, it's available in 12 shades. Well, go Benefit. It will retail for $22 or you can get 4 mini shades for $13. Wait, so they have 12 regular sizes. I will repeat, 12 for $22 or 4 mini shades for $13. Especially for such a big brand as Benefit. It's really, really lacking. So, Yeah, and they should just make minis of all the shades, basically. Because they are a big brand, you know. If this was an indie brand, small indie brand, I could understand it. But Benefit, come on, you know you can do better. So let's go to the next thing from Benefit, which are two new highlighters in the shade Cookie and Tickle. And I think that a lot of people were really, really interested in this because of the shade Cookie. What I understand, it's a very, very popular shade, and they have now released it as a single. So I have not tried any of the face products from Benefit. Let me know if you are excited for this. They retail for $30 each. The only thing that I kind of have an issue with those loose things are the packaging. I like it, but I also don't, because I like to use different kinds of brushes, and those raised borders kind of annoy me as well, you know. So I haven't tried anything. I was eyeing one of the minis, but that's so mini that I cannot kind of swirl my brush in. That annoys me, so that's the reason that I haven't tried anything. But let me know if you are interested in it. Oh yeah, now we are going to get to my drugstore segment. The stuff that I have from drugstore, which is a few things. So I forgot to mention some things. Oh, I forgot to mention this palette when it released. I just missed it. I don't know how. Oh, and that's the new mini Zodiac from BH Cosmetics, their Virgo palette. I had such high hopes for the mini Zodiac collection, and they kind of started a little bit slow, and then they released some palettes that were actually really pretty. I have some palettes here. The quality is very, very good though, I have to say that. But this though, oh, I'm sorry, but it's so boring. And it reminds me so much of the other palettes that they have brought out. This is such a missed opportunity. And yeah, I'm kind of getting pissed off by it. Which is a shame, because the whole idea was really, really nice. I was really excited for all the 12 eyeshadow palettes, and I was sure I would get all 12. Now though, there's one that I'm still interested in, and the rest of what they are releasing is just not it, guys. I do have to say, the experience that I have with this mini Zodiac palettes is that they look better in person than on the pictures. Does that make any sense? I do see a lot of people liking this color story. I also know a lot of people do not like this color story. If you have it, let me know how the color story is and if you are happy with it and all that goodness. It's just, for me, it's just so not it. So the next thing that I have from BH Cosmetics is a new palette. It's the Take Me to Ibiza palette. It features 35 shades of vibrant, neutral and smoky color shadows, perfect for long summer days and dancing the night away. For me, it will get lost in my collection, because I have a larger collection now. I don't need this. But if you are just starting out, or you know you don't have these colors, I think this will be a very nice palette if the quality is good. Yeah. Then this is a nice, could be a very nice addition to your collection, or if you don't have a collection, it could be a very nice palette for you. Yeah, I don't know again about the quality. I haven't seen any reviews on it just yet. So if you know if the quality is good, let me know down in the comment section below. Let's go to ColourPop, because yeah, ColourPop releases something every week, I think. Have I missed anything? Any new releases from ColourPop while I'm talking about this? No. Not just yet. Again, I'm pre-filming, so it could very well be that when this goes live, they have released another collection. But yeah, the last thing that they have released is their peach collection. I have seen it compared to their their peachy palette that they released in spring. It's almost the same. So if you have that one, you don't need this one, and vice versa. It's not that I am hating the color story. Absolutely not. It's just that it is not new. And they did the same thing with their rainbow collection. That is also not new. And I'm kind of pissed off about that. The other annoying thing is, I kind of want this palette. And I also kind of want the strawberry creamy palette. So I'm kind of, yeah. You know? I'm just going to move on. The whole internet was buzzing about this. So yeah, yeah. Let's go to Makeup Obsession. Because they have released a new Intoxicated with Love palette. It's available now. And it kind of reminds me of the Venus. The Lime Crime palette, to be quite honest with you. Do I have swatches? Let me see if I have swatches. I don't think so. I don't think I have. No, I don't have swatches. I'm not hating this color story either. Again, it reminds me of the Venus, the Lime Crime one. So if you do not have Lime Crime money, like I do, don't have, maybe this is something for you. I think that you can create similar eye looks with this one compared to the Venus one. So yeah, that was my drugstore part. Let's go to Lethal Cosmetics, because I have been mentioning them a few times the past few weeks. Here you see a picture of their full collections, the two new full collections. You have the Skyward collection. It's full of beautiful blue, bold blues and greens with a dreamy metallic mint and a brand new highlight shade. And then you have the Landfall collection. It has two pigmented pinks, a mini range of neutrals, and a stunning lavender with a bright silver reflect. So yeah, they look pretty. I'm not going to lie, I would not hate owning this whatsoever. But yeah, no, I'm also not going to grab them now. Does that make any sense? I'm still a little bit overwhelmed. I'm still in my first impression. Well, now it's 2 weeks instead of 1 week. So yeah, I think it's pretty. I know that the quality is amazing. Let me know if you are going to grab anything. Oh yeah, I think this is a new... Is this a new brand or is it just new for me? I have no idea if this is a new brand or just new for me, but it is I Buy Beauty. They have released a beautiful palette called Enlighten. Yes. This picture is from the Indie Mood, and she saw it in person at Indie Beauty Expo, and apparently it was stunning. It looks to be, I'm trying to describe it, a pastel neutral and a little bit of mauve color. I don't really know. It's intriguing. Let me know down below what you think of it, if you know the brand and all that goodness. Oh yeah, let's go to this from Mecca Max. They have launched their newest palette. It's called Sugar Queen. It's an eye and face palette. 15 oversized pigments for eye, cheek and highlight in marbled pastels, wearable neutrals and versatile mattes and metallic shades. It is available now for $38. It's an Australian brand and I think it's pretty. And you know, we always complain that America kind of forgets that Europe exists. But it's not just us, you know. Australia is huge. It's always overlooked. New Zealand, same. Always overlooked. So when I find brands like this, I always want to mention them. So yeah, I think it's really, really pretty. Let me know down below if you know of the brand, if you are excited and if you are getting how the quality is, you know, all that goodness. I think it's pretty. So yeah, it's an Australian brand. I like it. Okay, let's see if I have anything more interesting than I wanted to. Oh yeah, I got tagged in this one as well from Give Me Glow Cosmetics. So let's talk about that one as well. It's their Vintage Rose palette and lipstick. It launches the 30th of August. They have sneak peeked this, so I mentioned it a while back. But now you see the colors and they are very, very pretty. I am not going to lie. Very, very pretty. Do I know what it will retail for? Let me see if I can find out. I'm hungry. Oh no. Oh, I also have swatches. So let me... You know I have I think I need to stop because my Instagram does not want to play nice anymore. Oh, here it is. Okay. So I also have the swatches here. Oh god, that looks so gorgeous. Oh, these look so, so pretty. I have no idea what it will retail for though. It will probably be a lot of money. I think it is above my price. Well, I know it is going to be above my price range, but it is very, very, very pretty. But yeah, let me know if you are excited, if you are getting it. Let's kind of wrap it up a little bit. Because otherwise this video is going to be a nightmare to edit. I think it's already going to be a nightmare to edit. Let's go to Beauty Bay. They have collabed with Mitchell. That name, am I the only one who is annoyed by that? Is it Mitchell? Is it Mitchell? I don't know. It's annoying. I am going to just say Mitchell because it annoys the hell out of me. I'm hungry. Can you tell? So, yeah, my fangs are a little bit growing and I'm getting salty because I kind of need to eat. This palette is not helping. So let's start with what I like about it. I kind of like the color story. Yeah, you have one warmer side, you have a cooler side, and it is a little bit neutral. I don't hate that. However, I remember that, who was it Too Faced or Tarte? I don't know who did that, but they kind of released a palette like this, where they had the mirror in the mirror that you could remove. This is the same kind of... Why? Yeah, it's not new and unique, because it has been done before, although everything has been done before. I kind of like the fact that you can take out the mirror and that you can put it somewhere. I kind of like that, but I also don't. You know what I mean? I don't, yeah. Yeah, the colors are pretty, but it's nothing new, people. So, unless you really like Mitchell, then I can kind of see people get excited about it. But color story wise, we have this a lot. Because apparently this is a thing now. So yeah, I'm not hating the color story, but yeah. Let me see. It's called the Me, Myself and Mitchell 32 Pan Pressed Pigment Palette. It is launching September the 1st for £30, $36 US or $54 Australian. Beauty Bay ships internationally, just so you know. Yeah. It's vegan and cruelty free. I like that. For the rest, yeah. Yeah, someone says here actually in the comments, it reminds her or him, I'm sorry, I don't know, about the Be Perfect release. And I kind of agree. You know, it's nothing new. It's not for... Nah. But maybe it is for you. Let me know down in the comment section. This is the last... Is this the last thing? No, goddammit, I have more. And I kind of want to mention them. I'm sorry, this is going to be such a long video. I'm sorry, editing me. It's going to be a nightmare. Let's go to, Focalure Beauty. Because they released this. They are also on a yellow roll. The new Smile palette. The swatches look really, really pretty. And yeah, this is kind of what the ColourPop yellow palette should have been, in my opinion. I have ordered a yellow, all yellow palette from a Beauty Glaze that I'm waiting on. I ordered it from AliExpress. Maybe I need to see if I can find this one as well, because Focalure is also sold on AliExpress. That's how I know of the brand. So yeah, it retails for $10, I think. I'm going to see if I can find it on AliExpress, which is kind of annoying because I just placed another order. But yeah, I think this is really pretty. The last thing that I have, I promise, this is the last thing, is from MO Cosmetic. Is it live already? Yeah, it is. Wait, what? It's a Firefly collection, but this is a different palette than I see here today. So I have two pictures. And I'm confused. You see, the first one without the arm is the first picture that I saw, which has a very, very bright green. And then you have the one with the arm, which has a darker green. So I don't know if it is the lighting per se. But yeah, it is the Firefly, at least the one with the arm, is the Firefly collection. It features 5 richly pigmented matte shadows. palette in palette form or in loose powder form, a cream shadow, a pressed glitter, and while supplies last, free full-sized blushing highlighter. It's available on her Etsy shop. It looks really pretty.
I'm very much into greens
at the moment. So yeah.
So she does ship worldwide through her Etsy store.
But yeah guys, that was basically it. I think it's pretty. I'm not gonna lie. I do have to say though, that I kind of have this in the Lila 2 from Blush Tribe. And then there I have a combination of mattes and shimmers. So yeah. This was it. Finally. So I hope I can edit it all down a little bit and the video won't be too long. So yeah, I had so much to talk about today. It was just insane, hence the fact that I pre-filmed 2 days in advance. Because usually I film it either a day before or on the day that it goes up, on Monday. But I had so much that I just need the time to edit everything. So yeah. Let me know down below if there was anything that piqued your interest and maybe you have different opinions than me. That is all totally fine. Let's just have a friendly discussion down in the comment section. Yeah, I need to eat. I'm so hungry. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so very much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I hope to see you soon in my next one, which will be tomorrow for a first impression. I don't know which palette will go up tomorrow, but there will be a first impression going up tomorrow. So, yeah.